Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's check the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And as we see, the market has recorded some mixed price dynamics. So some cryptocurrencies have increased in price. The others have declined slightly. But I would say that after the solid price increase, the major cryptocurrencies at the moment are just consolidating. However, I expect continuation of the price increase in the near future, but not based on technical analysis, neither fundamental, just it's like my sentiment toward the markets. So I think the positivity continues. But today I want to say that I will comment on the price chart of HIVE, because usually recently we have been talking a lot about the major cryptocurrencies and their prices. Definitely, this is one of the most interesting part in the cryptocurrency world at the moment, because we see that the major cryptocurrencies, they are increasing in value. But since we're also active users of HIVE blockchain, HIVE is our beloved cryptocurrency. That's why we have to keep an eye on it. And then let's cross our fingers for HIVE and hope that it will follow the price dynamic of the major cryptocurrencies as well. And before I start and before I comment today on the price chart of HIVE that is currently trading at the level of 13 cents 0.52, I just want to mention some useful statistics that I use on a daily basis and that Pingyun Pablo published actually on a daily basis. And he has a post about the weekly, let's say, withdrawals and deposits from and to exchanges. And I want to show that some useful statistics here. So this is HIVE stored on all exchanges. Huobi is still the key or the biggest crypto exchange, followed by Binance. So to some extent, they are very similar if we compare the volumes, the HIVE volumes or amounts stored on this exchange. Then comes Bittrex, Nice Exchange, and so on. And what I want to say is here, we can see the weekly HIVE deposits and withdrawal to and from these exchanges. And what makes me happy that recently the situation has improved a little bit. We see that from Huobi there has been a withdrawal recently. From Binance there has been a withdrawal for the last week recently. It used to be different, because if we check the previous statistics, you will see that before there were net transfers to Binance that were more than the withdrawal. So now I'm really very happy that I see that some cryptocurrency users are probably taking advantage of the current price of HIVE. They're buying HIVE and they're withdrawing the cryptocurrency. Of course, Bittrex has some positive, let's say, net transfer, but I'm pretty sure that one of the reasons is that Huobi blocked the accounts, the HIVE accounts of many the HIVE funds of many users for almost 2 months because of the hard fork. I also suffered this, let's say, negativity, to be honest, from Huobi, and I decided never to use them again. And now people, they're just withdrawing and removing their funds probably and transferring some of the funds to Bittrex. But this is just my point of view. But what we still see is that Upbit still has a very solid influx of HIVE. 3,657,000 HIVE net. This is the net amount transferred to Upbit. And I still think that some whales, they power down because of the hard fork that took place in October, and they are leaving HIVE, and probably many of them are located in Asia, and that's why they use Upbit. But this is just my assumptions, I'm not pretty sure, but I still see that there is a solid net transfer of HIVE to Upbit. Let's hope that the situation improves in the next 2 or 3 months. So once again, at least I'm happy that we have this positive, let's say, withdrawals from Huobi and Binance, so probably some people are taking advantage of the nice price of HIVE. Also, before I start commenting to comment on the price chart of HIVE, I just want to remind you that 7 days ago I wrote a post about the price chart of HIVE and I outlined this technical pattern called cup and handle. So this is actually how it looks like, and usually it is considered to be a trend reversal pattern. Of course, we didn't have this solid price increase here. The price just tested the resistance line, but anyway, we didn't have a resist exit from the cup and handle. But anyway, even the attempt to form this cup and handle was something that I think is positive, because we see that hype is trying to reverse the trend. And that's why today I will comment once again on hype, because I see one potential, another additional positive signal indicating potential trend reversal. Now let's move on to the price. So this is the price chart. Let me start from the monthly time frame. I will remove all those unnecessary things on the chart. First of all, last month, a small Doge formed here. So to some extent, I won't say that this is a very super positive candlestick, but at least it indicates that hype is nearing some bottom, in my view. Of course, we know that the price is 13 cents and a half and the space to zero is declining, and that's why it explains to some extent this candlestick. But at least I am happy that I see that we have probably hit some really solid support, and that's why this Doge formed here. Now, if we switch to the weekly chart, the situation is really very interesting one, because we now have sequence of candlesticks with small bodies, such as this Doge, a shooting star, this small candlestick, another Doge called long leg Doge. Of course, this long leg Doge has a local low below the previous one, and we know that last week there was a lot of price volatility. But it is important to outline that it also has a local high above the previous one. So it is also to some extent some bullish signal. And I want to say that I'm really very happy that I see at least its body is slightly above this one. So to some extent, we have very slight positive signal here. And luckily now we have a bullish candlestick that follows that long leg Doge. The most interesting part I will comment on is on the daily chart. And fellas, probably you remember that we talk about this descending triangle, descending channel, so the downtrend on the price chart of Hive. That is easily much more visible, to be honest, on the 4-hour chart. That's why let's switch to the 4-hour chart. And let's remind you that we had this exit here, exit from the downtrend or from the descending channel. So this was the exit, the first attempt. However, the bears were able to revert the price increase, and they really the bulls faced really solid resistance, and the bears were able to sink the price back to the upper line of this descending channel. I conducted a technical analysis exactly within this, let's say, time period, because I said I will be really very happy if I see another price rebound that will open a favorable position, favorable, let's say, situation to enter the market. And now let me try once again to remind you and to explain you how conservative traders work, what they do in such case. So now we have a second rebound from the upper line of the descending channel. So it seems that definitely the price of Hive is trying to change the direction of the price chart. Probably it is the beginning of some trend reversal. But conservative traders, they wait usually for this second price rebound. And only if the price during this second rebound or a subsequent one surpasses the level of the previous local high, so that this is the local high from the previous rebound, let me even switch to a linear chart, then they enter the market. This is the territory or the zone within which they will start to enter the market when the price surpasses this local high. So this is what I want to outline. So we're very close to such kind of potential trend reversal. That's why I will constantly keep an eye on the price chart of Hive. If it happens, definitely I will buy some additional Hive. Of course, there are much more conservative traders that even wait when this price rebound, if it happens, and if the price surpasses the previous local high, they wait for additional price decline, and they wait to check if during this price decline, this previous local high will serve as a support. And once it happens, if it happens, and if the price rebounds once again, they enter the market here, because now they understand that there is a support already here and we are far away from the upper line of the descending channel. But this is the most conservative traders. To be honest, I enter the market very aggressively here and I bought high, for example, I bought, let me show you, I even mentioned this many times. I bought Hive here in November. I bought Hive here. I bought Hive here. So I'm slightly accumulating my position because I am a user of Hive blockchain. And I hope that in the long run, definitely we will have a higher price than the current one. So fellas, that's it for today about my update on the price chart of Hive. Please share your point of view as a comment under this video. Of course, I wish you a very wonderful day. Good luck in the financial markets and hope to see you in the next one. That was me again at CryptoSpa.